Sandberg Guitars has released a new California TM series, the Grand Dark. This one comes with a Darkglass preamp, with a plexi pickguard, and with a 35-inch scale, even for the 4-string basses. So, let's check it out. This is Gregor from Bassdevil.com, and before I can get this video properly started, I have to give you a short disclaimer. Yes, I'm sitting here as the Bassdevil.com review guy and doing all the talking in our videos. I'm talking about basses and amps and pedals with my beautiful Eastern German accent, which is arguably one of the best. But I have to tell you at this point that I'm also working for Sandberg whenever I'm not doing, well, I have other jobs as well, but one of my other jobs is working for Sandberg. I'm their PR guy, I'm their artist relations manager also, and this will of course give you the right to call me biased whenever I'm reviewing something that is Sandberg related here on this channel. That's why I will try not to judge the instrument itself and just tell you what it can do and what it can't. And hopefully this will make still a proper review. So let's get started. Ingredients of the Grand Dark are still very typical Sandberg, and yes, it's actually pronounced Sandberg because it's German, but we are talking English here, that's why it's absolutely okay to say Sandberg. The body is made from alder, the neck is bolt on and made from Canadian hard rock maple. The fingerboard is made from Pau Ferro, which is one of the new default standard fingerboard woods at Sandberg. As you might have heard, the new size regulations make it a lot harder for manufacturers to sell rosewood, which is still available, but now causes an upcharge. So they, yeah, Sandberg had to look for a new default wood on the darker visual side, and yeah, went for Pau Ferro, which is still very common wood. Has been in the instrument market for decades already. It's very common, but now you will see it much more often, not only at Sandberg basses, I guess. Sound-wise, it's a little bit in between maple and ebony, so it's definitely harder and harsher than rosewood used to be, but I think especially with this bass here, which is not only, but also definitely a little bit aimed at metal guys or whatever metal genres are called nowadays. I have no idea about these things, but we have this super long scale, we have the Darkglass preamp, which is definitely popular amongst these metal gent whatever guys. Having this Pau Ferro neck with his, this punchy fast attack definitely makes sense. And I think with these nice treble frequencies coming out here, which are a little bit sharp, they will help you a lot to cut through the mix if you have to fight against very loud and powerful guitars. Grand Dark comes as a 4 and as a 5 string, and you can choose from 3 different finished versions at the moment. This one here is the Sanremo Blue Hardcore Aged, and if you don't like aging, you can get the same color also as a high gloss finish. And if you don't only want to have your bass called something with dark, but also want them to look dark, you can choose the matte black ones, and these are made with ash bodies. Sandberg takes aging very seriously, so it's not only the finish that has been damaged by their professional bass butchers, but also the gunmetal hardware. The pick Hiccups in the Grand Dark is the brand new California TM Plus set, and those have never been in any other Zandberg model before, so this is the first series. They are kind of similar to the ones that you might know from the regular California TM series basses, but they are a little bit fatter sounding and have a little bit of emphasis in the low mids, which is really cool, and they have this little cross in the logo. In the bridge position we have a humbucker, and in the neck position we have the single coil, which is technically also a humbucker because it's a hum cancelling pickup, so it's also a humbucker, just not as fat sounding as the one in the bridge. And here on the control plate we have this little switch that allows you to split the humbucker and the bridge position. Three-band EQ comes from Douglas and it's their tone capsule preamp. We have a master volume, which is also an active passive switch. We have the balance control for the pickups. We have a mid control, bass control, and trebles are stacked, so to save some space here. And another cool feature with all Zandberg basses is when you're playing them in the passive mode, in this case it's the mid control becomes a passive tone, which is very practical. Grand Dark is of course aimed at players who really enjoy great definition in the lower strings, in this case the E string, or if you buy a 5 string on the B string, and I can imagine that there will actually be a good bunch of players who buy a 4 string version, take a 5 string set, take the lower 4 strings and put them on here and use this kind of a fake 5 string without the high G string, because this is something that is more and more common and usual to see nowadays, which is really cool. With this longer scale you have a great definition down there, and I think especially with this wood combination with the Power Ferro you're cutting through the mix in a very nice way, and it's a little bit metal but not so metal that I would say it's only be usable in these kind of genres. I think this is a bass that you can still bring to any jazz or blues or whatever gig. This is still a kind of normal sounding Zandberg, whatever a normal sounding Zandberg is, but however, you've heard it, you can slab it, you can do anything, it just sounds, oh no, it doesn't sound great. I can't say that because, you know, I'm working for Zandberg. However, that's my review. If you have any further questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I will gladly get back to you. And if you like this presentation, it's not a review, then feel free to subscribe to this channel. It's free, and there will be more reviews of any kind of bases also from other companies as Zandberg. Yeah, also don't hesitate to hit the like button, this helps us out as a channel and creates more attention to our videos. That would be very nice. That's it for today, see you next time, and have a wonderful week. Bye bye.